Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another one of my videos. This is XFSteph, right back right now. I know that I haven't been posting anything in the last month or so. I'm really sorry for that, but I have been busy with a lot of projects and stuff that I've been doing. Hopefully I will be finished with something. I will be posting another video on that one. It's a personal project that I'm working on, and hopefully I'll be successful. But anyway, let me just go ahead and talk about this video right now. This is going to be a Emperor Nobleman housing block playthrough. There, I've said it. I did this like a thousand times and didn't work out. But anyway, as some of you may know, those of you who have watched my videos, I did do a lot of videos on games and stuff on Emperor and stuff related to it, like housing blocks and playthrough. Let me just go ahead and show you some of the this is the normal housing blocks that I use. Actually, these are two housing blocks mixed into one, you know, on the length. Depending on the map sizes, you can actually make bigger ones. This map right here was from the campaign, from the Sui campaign, and it wasn't going all that well. Let me just check something really quickly. Okay, so it's still recording. And this is a 12 noble house housing block that I've did for this campaign. As you can see, these are all heavenly compounds. And luckily for me, this map is not a military map, so I do not have to make military units. But if it were, then I would be able to go all the way up to all the way up to 16 forts. Let me just go ahead and load another game. I think this one. Yeah, exactly. This is the main map, and this is a 14 heavenly compound housing block that I've made. I actually love this one, but of course, these the Thai gardens, Thai parks, Tai Chi parks, and the private gardens are all, you know, a bit of a overkill, so to say, as they were not needed, but I did have the space, so I said, what the hell, I should just as well do them. So, all of the 9 animals are looking good. Now, what I will be doing is starting a new game, and everybody, hopefully, will be actually, you know, playing, watching these. These are going to be like half an hour videos of me playing this. The map that I'm choosing is multiplayer 25. I will be adding normal difficulty, medium, high density of cities, because you will need a lot of people to react with. Neutral, rare disasters, because I don't like that. And let me just go there and put in some, you know, some monuments for me to make. Alright, so this is the map. I've paused it right now. Now, the first thing that you need to do when you start playing a game in Emperor, whether it be in the campaign or not, is that you look at what you have to do. Obviously, 300,000 population is not something that you can achieve in this game. But you may want to look at your resources. So right now I have rice, paddies, wheat fields, hemp, of course, this is really good. I have mulberry trees and tea, which means that I can make silk, tea. I also have fishing, quays, and hunter tents. Considering the fact that we have rice paddies and wheat fields available, I will probably not be going for fishing, quays, and hunter tents in the beginning of the, or maybe later on in the game. I'm not sure right now. I have pheasants, I have a lot of water, some... okay, so basically you also need to look at the industry. Obviously, I am in Steel Age and I will probably be needing military. I can make all sorts of units and troops, but the problem is that I cannot make any sorts of steel, which means that I will probably need to have a very, very big economy for me to work on it, because I will be able to make weaponsmiths, but I'm not able to make steel, which means that I have to import it. Let's see, we have the clay pit, that's always good. We have the logging shed, that is also good. We've also got kilns, lacquerware maker, weaver for the silk, paper maker, and jade carvers. Okay, so obviously, the first thing that we will try to do is sell silk. Let's just go ahead and... Kashgar buys silk. Marvelous. This means that our economy can get underway almost at the beginning of the game. Good. Also, the next thing to do is to look at the map. Look at your resources first, whatever resources you have, and then look at the map and decide where you will want to be playing. Now, for this map right here, it doesn't look all that good. Usually you should try to position your housing blocks somewhere near to not so fertile positions, or positions that don't offer large expanded room for you to build. I'll just choose this position right now. This is where I'll have my first housing block. Now remember, for you to build a housing block, you will need to I'll need to put the road somewhere down here, I think. Actually, let me just go ahead and yeah, this is where the wall will be, the exterior wall. Okay, now the house is two places thick, and the extra wall, this is where the road will be placed at. Now this will be the length of the road. I forgot to actually see how long that is. Actually, let me just go ahead and see. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, I think 12. Should that be enough for my houses right now? Okay. And 8 on the side. So 2, 4, 6, 8. Now this should be my block right now, and it should be the exterior road that goes outside of it. In the middle of it, there will be, of course, the marketplace. Let me see if I've got this right. No, I didn't. Of course I didn't. I always make some kind of stupid mistake. Okay, so I... I've actually made two mistakes. Balls to me. Does this actually fit in right here? Let me see. 2, 4. Not actually sure that this fits in this place right here. At least not like this. Maybe on the other side. Okay, let me just go ahead and start all over. As you can see, deciding exactly where to place your houses isn't that easy of a job. And by easy, I mean it's not easy at all. Alternatively, you can just go ahead and play the game without losing any time and, you know, practice on this. Maybe I can actually fit it right here somewhere. Or I could actually just go for this place right here, as it is quite neatly tied in here, and I'm not going to be able to make anything else in that spot. Yeah, I think I'll do it here. Let me just go ahead and delete the road. Okay, so this is where the houses will be. Okay, this is the wall, the house, the extra road, and this is the side road. The side road should be 8 place long. 2, 4, 6, 7, actually 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay. And this should be the bigger one, consisting of 12. Okay, so obviously I'll need to move this road somewhere here. I will place the market I don't know. Does it matter which side? I think it matters, though. On this side, I'll place it here. This will be the exit. Let me just go ahead and put the... Actually, wait. 2, 4... Okay, so obviously I've did a mistake again. I'm not sure where I am constantly screwing things up. But I reckon I can go... I actually haven't been playing this game since I've did my last tutorial, so don't be too judgmental on me right now. This isn't coming in any easy than it should be. Okay. Just I've connected that one right there. This one goes away. Let me just go ahead and place the roads. Alrighty, and now come the houses. And as mentioned in my videos, you have to start from near the exit of your town. Alright, looking good. Finally. I'm sorry for the delay. Let me just go ahead and put some... One food shop, one hemp shop, one ceramics shop, actually. Yeah, I'll just leave it like that for now. Obviously the well, the herbalist, acupuncturist, and the inspector tower are required. Okay, no feng shui for him. Shrine is also needed, and I'll have to leave space for one Buddhist or Taoist shrine, but I will do that a bit later. Oh, and the taxpayer, of course. But for the taxpayer, I'll have to make the administrative city first, which I will do. Maybe not there. Although, yeah, no, it's pretty fun. It's good. We're good. And the inspector tower, of course. Let the pause. Placing the brown walls. Of course. Not brown, of course, but placing them, of course, I mean. That is always important. Good. And you can go ahead and beautify. Wait, what? You can go ahead and beautify your city even from the get-go, so that you don't forget about it later and, you know, end up having problems because of it. Good. Oh, also, tax office is there. One place for one house. Actually, I'll leave the place there. Alright, that looks good, I think. I hope. Anyway. Great. Also, what we need right now is to make food. Food is the most important, obviously. You can use the space right here to build stuff like your mills. And you can obviously also make one storage yard. And actually I'll just make two of them because I'm feeling a bit lucky. Don't forget your inspector tower as well. Just put them there. And one mill should be enough for now. Each of your storage warehouses should be set to accept only ceramics and obviously only hemp, which is actually quite important for the beginning of the game. Good. Okay, another two those can be put right there. Looking good. Now, this place right here will be used for some farms, because obviously it wasn't possible. Rice usually needs a lot of really good grass. This is okay, but not the best. I'll be starting with some wheat houses. I'll just be putting two of these right here. Now, obviously, you have to make sure that you have enough place to put them. Put one right there. One, two, three, and another one to the left. Okay, wheat. There we go. Okay. I'll probably do some hemp right here. Some hemp houses. Now I'm doing this as I'm going along, so. Forgive me for my delays and my possible mistakes. I am, though, only human. Oh, there we go. That was a big one. Obviously. Okay. Another inspector tower right here should have been more than enough. Also, there is a lot of nice place right here for me to put some actually not right here, but right this isn't all that good either. I'll just put one here, one rice farm. So then the road will be here, three spaces inwards, three spaces upwards. This is the first one. Okay. I can also use this space right here to build a couple of logging sheds, which, you know, will be quite useful as you know, you might need wood sometime in the future. But just make sure that the wood industry is shut down, because you do not need that right now. You can also shut down the hemp at this point. You just need food at the beginning of the game. That's the most important part of all. Good. Nice. Here we go. Okay, as you can see, I cannot make that one right there, but... okay, another one should be put here. Okay, rice is going to be a bit tricky to harvest. Next step is to build some silkworms, silkworm sheds for you to make some silk. Now that we've got our thing down, if you're feeling a bit ballsy, you can actually start trying to trade with the other cities as well, but that won't be as important right now, considering the fact that, you know, I could have moved this whole joint a bit to the south. So this is an example of how I am actually just, you know, going as playing this game just as I'm going along with it. You can also make at the beginning of the game two paper makers. Okay. Two paper makers. And one storage house for paper. Where's paper? Paper. Half, of course. And wood. Half. Cannot see the wood. Wood, where are you? Good, great. Okay, so let's go ahead and let the game run. I think that I've did everything that was possible. In the meantime, it's a good idea Actually, that's a bit too fast for me right there. It's a good idea to see what kind of heroes we've got. Now, in this game, we've got all of them, and they're all content. This is good to be mentioned. As soon as you put one shrine down from either the Taoist or the Confucianist heroes, then they will start losing their content. So until then, you don't have any problems. Obviously, the first three are a problem because, you know, you have to put a special ancestral shrine there up away. So another good idea is to raise the wage rate of your citizens. Oh, and to shut down anything that doesn't, you know, go with your whole idea of a nice city. We've got 100 employees, but we need about 200 more, 300 more for the gameplay. Okay, as you can see the people are still coming in. The rice paddies are working right now. Some would judge that you could do some fertility changing, you know, if you got it, whatever. Also, make sure that you can accept everything that you have. Like, you know, you can put this at... Wait one second. Actually, nothing. Accept... What is max? 32. Put wheat and rice, in this case, at 16. So that we get the maximum amount of food right there. Okay, so the next thing that they will need is plant food. Just go ahead and speed things up a bit. The harvest begins in March. Okay, so another 2 months until the harvest begins. No festival. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, so they are working pretty neatly. It seems like I'm going to have a pretty nice harvest this year. As you can see, everything that I've built right now and the amount of workers needed is just enough for the inspectors, the farms, and that's it. No entertainment as of right now, only one ancestral shrine. And just, you know, that's all, that's everything. Also, it would help to place some roadblocks here, because it's going to speed up things. So although the fertility isn't all that high, I do have a pretty high production, which should ensure the next level in housing block, in my housing block. Okay, here we go. This is the next level, which needs plain food and I think hemp as well. We are going to be getting another 200 people, so as soon as those come in and we establish that the food amount that we have is okay, that was a bit of an error on my part. I forgot about that one. Okay, so we have 500 population, but the main problem is that we're running out of food again. So what you want to be doing right now is either add yet another food income, like hunting, which I can actually do. Or just add, like, I don't know, 4 hunting spots. Okay, so obviously we have employees needed. No festival. It's quite hard to, you know... Let's just look at the food count, agriculture. Obviously we make a lot more wheat than we make rice because of the fertility. And... Wait one second. Hunters. And also, monthly supply in loads, that's not... That's not accurate. Don't trust that one. people aren't starving yet, which is also good. Let's just go ahead and okay, that was a bit of another problem on my part. Me not accepting the game meat. Okay, so the meat is keeping my people fed for, you know, at least a moderate amount of time. Now, once these houses evolve again, we can start making hemp. Actually, they already need hemp, so let's go ahead and activate the industry. It's August, and I think hemp usually begins in September. So, yeah, I timed it pretty neatly. As you can see, the mill is already starting to fill up. A good idea would be to build a second mill, but considering the fact that we don't have enough workers right now, you can just leave that aside. And what's happening? No hemp? Okay, so I'm coming to a bit of a problem right here as... as there is nobody working for the hemp farms. Not enough people, actually. Let me just go ahead and stop the game meat production for a while. What we need is hemp, not... price increase, not interested, at least not yet. We've got some unemployment, but what we need right now is a full load of hemp. That is the most important right now. Overall. Not only because of the population demands it, but also that we because of the fact that we'll need to start building our other what are they called? So then two music stands should be enough for right now. We need to start building the paper making industries. Those are also important. Another 200 people coming in. Once you have unemployment, just go ahead and open up all of your industries. Like game meat and paper. Also, check your religion from time to time. Yes, let's have it. They are content. Oh, they are unhappy. Okay. What can I do? Let me just give them some... oh... once you start getting paper, they will love paper, and that's going to be your savior, basically. Now the next thing is to get ceramics, of course, and I think I will do that. I think I will put these here. I just need to make sure. Yes, thank you. Okay, so obviously we can put some kilns here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually 4 are enough, more than enough. Put a road access to them, of course, and start making the clay pits as well. Four clay pits should provide enough clay for actually eight kilns, but I'm actually not going to push it right now. I'm just making some paper. Need to make sure that my gods don't start kicking the hell out of me. Another good idea is to make another mill at this point, but don't put it in the same location. You could do that, you could put it in the same location, but later on in the game when you need more types of food for your houses. Right now I'll just want to put it in another location so that I can I can make another housing block in the future as soon as I can. And I'll probably move this road up ahead a bit, and the mill will be here most probably. As you can see, a lot of food is coming in right now. And things are looking good. things are actually quite good. Good, so at this point we've been losing a lot of money and we can already start making some silkworm sheds and produce just as little silk as possible. Let me just go ahead and that's the trading point, which we can use, of course. Ceramic is coming in. Now, once ceramic is coming in, you will need acrobat schools for your housing blocks, and I do recommend using two of them. The drama schools and the theater pavilion is actually only needed for the for the noble house. Oh god, no. Kilns usually catch fire without any premise. I'm not sure what's up with that. I think they were trying to make us look stupid or something. Good. Okay, obviously these people are not happy. Oh my god, I just spent a lot of resources on that, and you can see, as you can see, these are already the almost the last type of apartment, the ornate apartments. You also need Taoist and a Buddhist building, or a Buddhist building to improve them, but I don't recommend doing it as you also need tea, and tea production cannot be made just off of one housing block. So the next part, stay tuned for the next part of my game. I'll pause it right here. Thank you for watching and listening, and please post comments if there was something that you didn't like in my video, or if you did like it. Thank you, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.